I want an explanation as to why those keys were missing or stolen.
I don't have an excuse, Mrs. Davidson. I think the only thing I can do is resign.
She's gone.
What are you talking about? Who's gone?
Well, the Latham baby. I just went to check her and she's not in her cot.
You do remember she was to be moved to another ward today, don't you?
Yes, sister, and it would be logical to assume that that's where she's been taken, wouldn't it?
Yes, sister, but her medical records are still here.
Sometimes I wonder how some of these people keep their jobs. Well, I certainly won't be chasing around after them. They can come back and collect them themselves.
Well, I could take them.
No, you could not. I will not have my nurses chasing around this hospital on time-wasting errands.
Yes, sister.
Oh, just a minute, nurse. I haven't seen Burns. Have you any idea why she's not in the ward?
Oh, well, I'm not sure, sister, but the night nurse said that Doreen was complaining of feeling ill. Perhaps she's gone home.
Well, this is outrageous. I'll be having a word or two with that young lady. She knows she should have reported to me first. If she wants to continue to work here, she'll have to do better than that.
Want to see me, Mr. Davidson?
Yes, Mr. Fletcher. Please sit down. I take it you've spoken to Sarah by now?
No, I didn't get a chance to last night. Look, Mrs. Davidson, don't you think we'd better find out why she escaped before we do anything?
Unfortunately, whatever the reason, she did not serve out her sentence. I realize how hard it must seem when she's obviously made such a complete rehabilitation, but I have no other choice.
Yes, I think she realizes that.
Then she's going to give herself up?
Well, I don't know. As I said, I didn't get a chance to talk to her.
I had hoped you'd come back with a more definite answer. I'm afraid I can't give her any more time. I shall have to inform the police.
Mrs. Davidson, you've spoken to her. You know what sort of a person she is. Just give her a couple of more hours. I'm sure she'll do the right thing.
I'm afraid I'm not prepared to wait any longer. I shouldn't have waited at all. If she does make a run for it, then it will be my responsibility.
Yes, but surely...
Mr. Fletcher, my mind is made up.
You will let me know what happens?
Of course.
Well, discuss it with your husband, Mrs. Lund. I'm sure he'll find it's worth the price. Well, if he doesn't, you'll just have to use your charm, won't you? Okay, I'll wait to hear from you. Yes. Yes, have a good day. Bye. I'm sure you've made the right decision.
I think I've made the only one possible.
Well, I'm glad you took my advice and not Jim Fletcher's. He had to say what he said. After all, he's one of them. Obviously, that's all he cares about.
I don't think it is.
Now, as soon as you get settled, let me know where you are and I'll send the rest of your clothes and some more money. I'm sure I can look after her until you get a new start.
I'm not going, Julian.
But the suitcase, I...
Look, Julian, it's no good. What kind of life could I have? It's been bad enough up till now. Always looking over my shoulder. Always waiting for someone to recognize me. Now that it's happened, I know it'll happen again. I can't go on running forever.
But if you go somewhere else, change your name, maybe they'll never find you.
Maybe they'll never find me. Maybe. How can I live like that? Do you think I could cope with the possibility of this happening again? And what's the point in working hard to build something up when it could all come tumbling around my ears at any time?
Just that I can't bear the thought of you going back in there again.
Well, maybe it won't be so bad this time. There's always the possibility my record on the outside will count for something.
I wish there was something I could do.
There is. You could look after that suitcase for me. There's something else you can do.
Oh, anything.
Don't stop being my friend.
Sister, the Latham baby wasn't moved to another ward.
Don't be ridiculous. She must have been.
Well, Nurse Jamison's just been sent here to collect her.
You sure she hasn't been moved already?
Well, yes, sister. I've checked the other wards.
Well, this is outrageous. How could someone just walk in and remove a baby without anyone noticing? Are you sure she's not in the building?
Quite sure, sister. I've searched everywhere.
Unless, of course, she was taken by someone who worked here, then the staff wouldn't necessarily pay much attention.
What do you mean?
What I mean is the Latham baby isn't the only one who's missing today.
You mean Burns?
That's exactly who I mean. Well, she's a logical choice. She's missing. She was very fond of the baby, and her background is unsavory, to say the least.
But surely she wouldn't just walk off with a baby.
There's no other logical explanation. You just wait here a moment. I'm sure the police will want a word with you. Oh, Dr. Henderson, this is Sister Brooks. One of our babies appears to have been kidnapped. Yes. I think I know who is responsible.
Hello.
Oh, good heavens, look who's here. Come on in.
Gee, thanks. I didn't think you'd ever want to speak to me again after the way I acted the other day, but you were really nice about me being a crim and everything.
Well, I meant it. Come on, come inside.
I didn't do anything really bad. Not really.
Well, we all make mistakes. You don't have to tell me a thing about it. Come on, come and sit down. Oh, what a lovely baby.
Yes, she is. You a good friend of my mum's?
Oh, well, we didn't spend an awful lot of time together, but we got on very well. I liked her. She's a really nice lady. Oh, she didn't mention that you had a baby.
Oh, well, actually, this is my sister's baby. She's having a lot of trouble with her old man at the moment, and I said I'd look after Elizabeth, you know, while they sorted their problems out.
Oh, well, now I'm really confused. I thought you were an only child.
Well, she's a foster sister, really. I don't suppose Mum wanted to go into it too much, you know.
Well, what do you say to us putting Elizabeth, did you say?
Yeah.
We'll put Elizabeth down to sleep in the spare room and you and I can have a cup of coffee and get better acquainted.
Yeah.
You work, don't you?
Oh, yeah, but not today. I was expecting some unwanted visitors, you know, family. I hope you don't mind.
Well, if you'd like, I'll help you look after her. She's a little sweetheart.
Yeah, and I got some money out of the bank today, and we're going to the country to stay with a friend for a few days.
Well, any time you want any help, you just ask. Come on, I'm dying for some coffee.
You are Jacki Nolan?
Yes.
You are to leave your jewellery and any other personal possessions you have with you on the counter. Then go and stand on the white line. Thank you. Would you type up a list of these things, please? Jacqueline Mary Nolan, you are charged with escaping from lawful custody. Do you understand? Do you understand the charge?
Yes. Yes, I understand.
Could you file these for me?
Remove all your clothes back there, and after I've searched you, have a shower and get changed.
Don't worry, I know the routine.
You can sign for your possessions when you've finished.
Yes, all right.
So, when she tendered her resignation, I had no alternative but to accept it.
I can't imagine Wentworth without Vera. She's almost a part of the place.
Yes, she is. You know, at times she has annoyed me beyond endurance. But on the whole, she's done her job well. You know, if there has been a problem with her drinking before this, I've never noticed it.
Well, I didn't notice anything until recently. And then I didn't think it had become enough of a problem to interfere with her work. Oh, I don't know. I feel a bit guilty about it.
Why on earth should you feel guilty?
Well, I've been so tied up in my own little world, I didn't notice that Vera needed help.
Well, outside our work involvement, I've really never known very much about her.
Well, you knew about her mother, didn't you?
Only that she was an invalid.
Oh, she was sick, all right, both physically and mentally. She made Vera's life hell for her. Vera was completely ruled by her mother, and by the time she died, Vera was... Well, you know what she's like now.
Oh, no. I didn't realize.
By the time Vera was free, well, she wasn't young anymore. She was totally alone and she didn't have a friend in the world. And what was even worse is that she didn't know how to make friends. She'd never been taught.
You say that she's only started drinking recently.
Well, as far as I know, but something must have happened to trigger it off.
Well, I wonder what it could have been.
I don't know. I do know that Vera is about one of the loneliest people I've ever met. You know, she was so eager to help me when I got out of hospital that it almost became embarrassing. Look, I know what she did is pretty unforgivable, but isn't there anything we can do?
Well, I could go around to see her. I don't know what good it will do, but it might salvage something out of this mess.
I hope so.
Erica Davidson? What? How did that happen? Well, let me know as soon as you hear anything, please. Goodbye. Would you bring Chrissy Latham here? Her daughter's been kidnapped.
I don't see what difference it makes, Jude, whether people think you're on with Trace or not.
Look, it makes no difference to me, but it matters a lot to Tracey.
Well, it's nobody else's business anyway.
B? For crying out loud, I've just told you there's nothing between us. Now, why would I lie to you?
Well, don't get yourself in a twist. If you're not, you're not. And I can't see what all the fuss is about.
Can't you understand? Tracey is straight. She can't cope with anything else. And she's a nice kid. I don't want her hurt.
I still think you're worrying too much. I mean, there's bound to be a certain amount of flack about anyone you share a cell with.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I might even have to ask to be put in a cell by myself.
You sure you feel up to working? Honest, Mrs. Jackson, I think it's better. I just don't want to be on my own.
Oh, Chrissy, what's up, love?
Oh, perhaps you ought to go back to your cell and lie down.
What's the matter, Chrissy? Is Elizabeth really sick? Mrs. Jackson?
Elizabeth's been taken from the hospital.
What do you mean, taken? Who took her?
She's been kidnapped. That's what she means.
Oh, don't worry, Mrs. Jackson. We'll take care of her.
Oh, don't worry, love. The cops will find her. They're very good at that. That's why all of us are still in here.
You know, I don't know very much about children, but that baby seems awfully hot to me. She's not sick, is she?
She's just had a bit of a cold, that's all.
Have you taken her to the doctor?
No, not yet.
Well, I think you'd better. I don't want to interfere, but she seems awfully flushed.
Yeah, well, babies often get like that. I'll take her later on, OK? Yeah. But first of all, I've got to tell them why I'm missing from work. So will you look after her for an hour for me?
Mm, sure.
Thanks.
What's the matter? You look as if you've seen a ghost.
Yeah, almost. Cops have pulled up outside my place.
Mm, where do you suppose they want?
There's probably been a robbery in the area or something, and they always hit the ex-crims first. I better go and talk to them.
Oh, do you want me to come with you?
Oh, no. I can manage on my own. Probably just want to ask me a few questions, you know. Hello, are you looking for me?
Are you Doreen Burns?
Yeah, what's the trouble?
We've just come from Wentworth General Hospital. We understand you disappeared this afternoon. You mind telling us where you've been?
Oh, of course not. I felt a bit crook, so I left work early. I've just been over to my neighbour's place to get an aspirin.
Do you know the Latham baby's disappeared?
Disappeared? Oh, gee, that's terrible. Do you know how it happened?
Yeah, well, we're asking questions of anyone who had a chance to take the baby without being noticed.
Well, I didn't see anything suspicious, because I would have told somebody right away if I thought anything funny was going on. I get it. You reckon I had something to do with it just because I've been inside?
Yeah, well, that thought did occur to us.
Well, just because I've been inside doesn't mean that I would do something like that. I mean, that's kidnapping. Anyway, what on earth would I do with a baby? You don't believe me, do you? Well, look, come in and have a look around. I got nothing to hide. I mean, that's awful.
After you, Mrs. Benson.
Who is it?
Vera, it's Erica Davidson. I'd like to talk to you.
Coming. Come in, Mrs. Davidson.
I hope I haven't come at an inconvenient time.
Oh, no, I was just having a rest.
Well, I won't keep you long. I just wanted to let you know that I hadn't passed your resignation on to the department. You've always done your job well in the past, and I thought you should have a chance to rethink the situation.
You mean you don't want me to res... But I thought... Oh, thank you, Mrs. Davidson, but I don't know whether I'd be able to handle the women again after this, let alone face the rest of the staff.
I'm sure you could handle the women. And as for the staff, well, I think if you give them a chance, you'll find they're all very understanding. Surely you don't want to leave Wentworth after all this time.
No, I don't.
I know you've had your personal problems.
What do you know about my personal life?
Well, I had a chat with Meg Jackson.
I should have known she couldn't keep a confidence.
Vera, she only told me things she thought I ought to know. Not to gossip, but to help you. There's nothing shameful about being lonely. We all go through that at some time or other.
Well, she shouldn't have said anything. It was confidential. Anyway, I'm not lonely. I've got friends. I just don't show them off like other people, that's all. And besides... I do have other interests.
I know that sometimes a drink or two seems to help, but it's not the answer, you know. It usually makes things much worse.
I don't know what that has to do with me. I only have a social drink now and then.
Vera, that incident at Wentworth...
It was a mistake, don't you see? I wasn't rostered. I wasn't meant to be working. But when I found I was needed, I wanted to help out. Well, that's what Wentworth means to me. It's my whole life.
You know, sometimes I think we're all mad. We go into that place every day. We complain about it. It makes demands of us no other job would make, and yet we all love it. I doubt whether any of us could leave. How could we trust it with anyone else? So please, think very deeply about it before you make your final decision.
Hello, Sarah.
Don't you think you should call me Jacki? That is my real name. Don't look so unhappy. I'm all right, you know.
The surroundings don't suit you.
Well, I must admit I wouldn't have designed it quite like this. Look, Jim, I don't want you to think I hold you responsible for my being here. In a way, it's almost a relief. Once I finish my sentence, I'll be able to start fresh.
Yes, I suppose it's for the best. It's just that... Well, we were just starting to get to know each other, and... Well, I was hoping that...
I know. I wish things could have been different for us.
Well, maybe we can make them different. Maybe we can start again when all this is over.
Oh, I don't know, Jim. You know the law. We'll be barred from seeing each other even after I'm released.
Yes, we'll worry about that when the time comes, eh? Come on, I'll take you to the laundry. Introduce you to some of the women.
Ladies, I'd like you all to meet Sarah. To meet Jacki Nolan. Hi.
Hello, love. What are you in for?
Fletch said to call you something else, didn't he, Jacki?
Yes, Sarah Forrest. That's the name I used on the outside.
Now, wait a minute. Nolan. Nolan, you're not the one that was involved in that escape from Barnhurst a few years ago, are you? The one that wasn't caught?
Well, not until now, anyway.
Well, what do you know? Anyone can stay out in the loose that long and not get caught deserves a medal. I'm Bea Smith. Come with the others. This is Lizzie Birdsworth.
G'day.
Your mouth's open, Lizzie.
Where'd you hide all that time?
Listen, we'll discuss that later and have a tea party. This is Chrissy Latham. She's a bit low at the moment. Her kid was sent to hospital sick and got snatched.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks. Over here we have Judy Bryant. This is the lady to like if you like ladies. And then we have Robin and Bev and Rita. But tell me, I'm dying of curiosity. Where have you been all these years?
Well, pretty close by. I changed my name and a friend gave me a job in his interior design shop. It was going really well, too.
So how come you're in here?
You wouldn't believe it. Your governor, Mrs. Davidson, came in to inquire about having some work done. She recognised me and...
Don't tell me Davo dubbed you in.
Well, she didn't really have much choice, did she?
Strike a lark, how bloody ridiculous. They're always screaming about rehabilitation, and there you are, as clean as a whistle, with a decent job, and what the hell do they do?
Hello?
Oh, Dr. Marshall? Erica Davidson.
Erica, my dear. We were just talking about you last night. Well, you must come out to dinner soon. We haven't seen you for so long.
I'd love to.
Now, what can I do for you? Not a professional call, I hope.
Yes, actually, but not for me. One of our officers needs a few days' rest. I won't go into the reasons, but I would consider it a favor if you could issue a medical certificate for her. It saves explanations with the department.
I see. Well, of course, I'd have to examine her first.
Oh, yes, yes, of course, I understand that. When would you be able to see her?
Well, I'm pretty busy right now, but, as it's for you, I'll see if I can pop around this afternoon.
I really do appreciate it.
Oh, not at all. Besides, pays to keep on the right side of the governor.
Oh, yes. Now, I'd better give you her name and address.
Yes?
I'm Dr. Marshall. Are you Vera Bennett?
Well, I don't understand. I didn't call a doctor.
Oh, Erica Davidson asked me to come and see you.
Come in.
Thank you.
I don't understand why Mrs. Davidson would have done that. I'm perfectly healthy.
Well, actually, she mentioned the fact that you needed a few days off. So, if I examine you and make out a medical certificate, the department won't ask any questions.
But I'm not ill. I don't know why Mrs. Davidson would want to deceive the department.
I'm sure she wouldn't dream of it, unless, of course, she thought you had a perfectly good reason.
But this will make it seem as if there's really something wrong with me.
Oh, I've known Erica for a long time. I don't think she'd deliberately embarrass anybody. Do you?
I suppose not.
Then why not let me get on with the examination? I mean, at the very least, you'll get a few days' good rest. I'm sure you work very hard at Wentworth.
We all do.
Good. Now, all Erica said was that you needed a few days off. I don't know what's going on, but a good rest shouldn't be too hard to take, should it?
Well, I have been feeling tired lately. All right. I don't see what harm it can do.
Very good.
Well, sister...
Just where have you been? The police are looking for you.
I know. They just came round to my place. Isn't it terrible about Elizabeth? I couldn't believe it.
Oh, me either. I just looked into a cot and there it was, empty.
Kidnapped, that's what the police called it. I wonder who could have done it.
Well, we thought it was...
That'll do, thank you, nurse. Get back to work.
Okay, sister. Now, I'd like an explanation from you. What happened to you this morning?
Gee, I'm real sorry, sister, but I felt crook, so I went home. I know I should have checked with you first, but I forgot. And it wasn't until the police came round that I remembered that I should have, so I came straight back here as soon as they'd left.
If you're feeling ill, perhaps you'd better report to casualty.
Oh, it's all right. I went to my own doctor and he gave me something. But I'm real sorry about leaving the way I did. Won't happen again, honest.
It had better not. I'm going to have to report it to the superintendent, you know.
Yeah, I suppose you will.
I still think this is ridiculous. I'm perfectly healthy, aren't I?
Well, I couldn't find anything seriously wrong.
There. I told you. Now, I really can't go along with this conspiracy against the department. I don't need a medical certificate.
Come now, Miss Bennett. I think conspiracy is going a bit far, don't you? Whether or not you'd like to admit it, you're very run down, and you need a good rest. You don't seem to realize that people are only trying to help you. It's a prescription for a tonic. That, and some rest should help you.
But I think I'm...
You may think, Miss Bennett, but I know. Perhaps that's why I'm a doctor and you're not. Good day. Thanks, Judy.
Good night, Jim.
Good night.
Jacki settling in all right?
Yes, I suppose so.
Must be very difficult for you with her in here.
I'll manage. Look, Meg, if you don't mind, I'd rather not talk about it.
Of course. I'm sorry.
I'd like to see Jacki Nolan, please. The name's Phillips.
Don't you think it'd be wiser to let her settle in first?
What's the matter, Mr. Fletcher? Don't you want me to see her?
I don't want to see her upset.
I've just spent most of the day consulting with her solicitors to try and find ways of getting her out of here. As far as I can see, all you've done is get her in. Now, which do you think she might find more upsetting?
If you'd just sign in here, please, I'll take you through to the interview room.
Thank you.
Well, it was a bit of a coincidence, old Davo coming into the shop, wasn't it? Not a very pleasant one, though.
Well, it wasn't really. Jim Fletcher recommended us to her.
How come?
Well, Jim and I have been seeing a bit of each other. We met at a party. The only trouble was, when we met, I didn't know he was a screw, and he certainly didn't know who I was.
Cool. That must have been a bit of a shock.
Yes, you could say that.
Must have given him a turn when he found you in here.
Well, not really. Actually, he advised me to turn myself in.
Oh, all men are bastards.
I don't think he's a bastard. Actually, I'm rather fond of him.
Of him? How can you be fond of him when he dubbed you in?
I wouldn't touch a bloke like that with a barge pole. Now, look, it had nothing to do with him. Erica Davidson recognised me. All Jim did was advise me to turn myself in instead of waiting for the police to come and pick me up. He let me make up my own mind. I'm grateful to him.
There's a visitor for you, Nolan. Mrs. Jackson's taking him to the interview room.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Well, now, there's a turn-up for the books.
I'm sorry, the rules are no physical contact.
Oh, for heaven's sake, what do you think I've done? Smuggled a file in or something?
He doesn't make the rules, Julian.
Yeah. Look, I've been talking to the solicitors most of the day, and they seem to think that they can base their case on the success you've made of your life outside, you know. Self-rehabilitation and all that sort of thing. Plus the fact that the business would go broke without you. It will, you know. Anyway, they seem to think that you'll get a lot of sympathy when it's discovered that you'll be right back where you started and broke as well.
Do they think they can get me off completely?
I'd like to say yes, but it looks like whatever happens, you're going to have to serve out your original sentence.
Oh.
It's not that bad. Looks like you mightn't have to do any extra time.
Yeah.
Well, what do I tell them? I mean, do they sound all right? They'll have to come and see you.
Look, you do what you think's best. Yeah, they sound all right to me. I don't really care what happens as long as I don't have to serve any extra time. That's the most I can hope for anyway.
Hello.
Bob! Oh, just look at me.
Yeah, well, actually, I came to take your lovely daughter Meg to dinner.
Oh, get off.
Well, maybe I'll take you instead, then.
Oh, thank you, Bob, but not tonight. I've had an awful day. I was just about to go to bed.
Well, why don't I get something for you? Now, I'm not much of a cook, but I could whip up something simple, like a boiled egg.
Honestly, Bob, I'm too tired even for that. I wasn't going to eat at all.
But you must, Meg. I had it all planned.
What are you talking about? Had what planned?
Well, the meal... The lights, the music, the wine,
well,
and then when everything was absolutely
tempting,
perfect, I was going
Bob,
to ask you to
please.
Marry me, but you are not being very cooperative. Now, I know it's not very romantic, Meg, but I really haven't had much practice. I've only ever said it once before. What do you say?
What I say is, you've made me very happy. Please, Bob, could you give me a little more time?
Okay.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Judy.
How are you feeling?
Okay. What's with those two?
Oh, well, the rumor is they're on together. Mind you, they're denying it.
Well, the prison certainly hasn't changed much. The dykes still manage to latch on to the young, pretty ones. Now, that one doesn't seem to be objecting too much.
She thinks I'm a lesbian, too.
Forget now, what'd you do that for?
Because they give me the creeps, that's why. I can't stand them anywhere near me.
You've been inside before. You know those sort of things happen to everyone. All kinds of people. It's no big deal. We're not hurting anyone, least of all you.
I just don't like them, that's all.
Well, then keep it to yourself. Tracy's a decent kid and I won't have anyone hassling her, not even you. Understood?
Okay. As long as they keep away from me.
Well, good. Then we should get along just fine.
Are there any new leads on the cases yet? We are following every possible clue. We do know what sort of person is likely to have taken the child. Someone insecure and unstable. In most cases of this kind, we found that the kidnapper is someone who has recently lost a child.
Does this mean that the child is likely to be treated well?
Well, that would depend on just how unstable the kidnapper is.
Is there any way in which our viewing public can help?
Well, if the person or persons who have taken Elizabeth Latham are listening to me now, the child is sick. I repeat, the Latham baby is in urgent need of medical attention.
Oh, God.
Will you please take the baby to the nearest hospital?
Oh, my God. She's going to die. I know she's going to die. It's her birthday. Well, don't they know that? Why don't they tell them, Mr. Fletcher? Tell them it's her birthday, and then they might bring her back to me.
Come on, Latham. They always make it sound worse than it is. Now, come on, back to your cell. I'll get you something to help you make you sleep from the dispensary. Now, come on. Give me a hand.
Doreen's pretty unstable at the moment, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, Dore, really. You don't mean you think that she could... Oh, B, what a dreadful thing to say.
Yeah, I suppose it is.
Dore has just lost that baby.
Hello, Jacki.
Morning.
Wait a minute.
What do you want?
Well, you've just come in and, well, everyone needs friends. And I thought if we got to know each other better, well, just friends, I mean, well, you must be lonely. I was when I first came in. I still am, I guess. Jacki?
Get your hands off me. Don't you ever touch me again. You people make my skin crawl.
Hey, what's going on here?
You better keep an eye on your little girlfriend. She was making a play for me.
Now, you listen to me, sweetheart. You just leave her alone, got it?
I wouldn't worry about her if I were you. I'm sure she's perfectly safe with a big, strong friend like you to protect
you
her.
Bitch!
You want your face up and up and down?
Just cut that out, Bryant. You all right?
Oh, terrific.
Go on, get to the laundry, all of you.
Come on.
You better go and get yourself together. Your father's here to see you, Morris, and be quick about it.
You know, if you keep this up, you're going to make yourself pretty unpopular. What is this big thing about lesbians?
You know that wonderful escape you thought was so great?
What about it?
It was stupid. I was eligible for parole in another couple of months.
So why didn't you wait?
Because a big dyke warder took a fancy to me, that's why. But I wouldn't be in it. So she started putting me on report. She made up all kinds of things. I was up before the governor two or three times a week. I never would have got my parole that way. So I gave in to her.
Well, couldn't you have hung out until your parole?
There wouldn't have been a parole. The lady decided she liked having me round. So she kept on falsifying reports to make sure I stayed in. Escape was the only way left.
Excuse me, I couldn't help overhearing what you were saying. I think that's really rotten. But we're not all like that, you know? Just like heterosexual people aren't all the same. Sure, I'm a lesbian, I never deny that, but Tracy isn't. Really isn't. She's just a kid and she's scared. And these rumors about her are making her very unhappy.
Now, come on. What do you say?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I just lost my head. When she touched me, I thought... Oh, hell, I didn't think. I just reacted. You know, if she really is your friend, maybe you should stay away from her. I mean, most people will think birds of a feather, you know.
All right, ladies, let's see some work being done around here, please. Oh, by the way, Chrissy Latham won't be working with you today.
Is she all right, Mrs. Jackson?
Well, I don't think she really will be until they find the baby. She's in the hospital at the moment. They're keeping her under sedation.
Mrs. Jackson, can I see the governor?
I suppose so. What's it about?
I just want to have a chat with Mrs. Davidson.
All right, I'll see if I can arrange it. In the meantime, could we have some work, please?
And they're all talking about me behind my back. They're saying horrible things. They all think that I'm having an affair with Judy.
Mr. Fletcher, can't something be done about that?
I don't see what I can do about it. It's the company your daughter keeps. I suppose the women think that there's no smoke without fire.
Mr. Fletcher, it's not true. I swear it's not.
Well, let it ride, then. They'll forget about it soon enough.
Perhaps he's right, darling. If you forget about it, maybe they will too.
Forget it? How can I?
Would some good news help? You know I've been seeing Mrs. Jackson. How would you feel if she was a permanent part of the family?
You're not serious. You mean marry her? I need you more now than I ever did, but you really don't care, do you? You said that we were going to be closer now, but that's just all lies.
Darling, we'll all be close. We'll all be together.
You're a liar. Mr. Fletcher, I want to go back.
Tracey.
I want to go back now.
Horace. Are you all right?
Haven't you heard? All us butch girls can look after ourselves. Mr. Fletcher, do you really believe what they're saying about me?
Well, it doesn't matter what I think, Tracey. It's them you've got to live with.
Don't be ridiculous, Tracey. Put it down.
What would you care? You'd have my father all to yourself then, isn't that what you want?
I can guess what brought this on. Now, you listen to me. Your father lives for you. He's sacrificed everything to give you a start in life.
It's never hard.
Of course not. He's out earning money so that you can have everything you want. Now, isn't it time you stopped being so selfish? Started thinking about him for a change.
I wonder if you could have a look at my baby, Doctor. I think she's pretty sick.
Why don't you sit down, please? Now, a name?
Mrs. Anderson. Mrs. John Anderson.
And how old's the baby?
Well, Elizabeth's almost one, but please, couldn't you have a look at her now? I'm real worried.
Now, Mrs. Anderson, you won't do you or the baby any good by getting all upset. Let's have a look at her, and then we'll take down the details afterwards, eh?
Oh, yeah, thanks, Doctor.
Well, over here, please. Thank you.
Here's a good girl. You sit there, Elizabeth. Good girl.
Oh, well, they haven't been starving you, have they, Elizabeth?
That's a good girl. Here.
How long's she been like this?
About a day, I suppose.
I don't want to worry you, Mrs. Anderson, but I'm going to make an immediate appointment with a specialist for you down at the Wentworth Hospital.
But I can't afford a specialist. Couldn't you just give me a prescription? I can look after her.
Mrs. Anderson, you must take her to the hospital right away. She's a lot of fluid on her lungs and it might be serious.
Oh, yes, Doctor. I'll get her there as soon as I can. Come on, Elizabeth.
Yes, Smith, what's the trouble?
Could I speak to you alone, Mrs. Davidson?
Thank you, Miss Watson. Now, what is it?
The girls and I are a bit worried about Chrissy's baby.
Yes, I know.
Look, don't get me wrong, but, well, after hearing that detective bloke on telly, well, I'm a bit worried about Doreen. She has just lost the baby and everything.
Yes, the same thing crossed my mind, but there's no need to worry. I checked with the hospital and apparently the police questioned her and are quite satisfied she had nothing to do with it.
Oh, thank God for that. I'd be terrible if she got in trouble now with having a good job and everything.
Well, according to the hospital, she won't have that good job for much longer if she continues to take sick leave without permission.
Do you think you could go and see her, Mrs. Davidson, and talk to her, tell her how silly she's being? Well, I know it's not your job, but, well, I haven't got a social worker we can ask.
As a matter of fact, that's exactly what I plan to do.
Thanks, Mrs. Davidson. It's funny how we see eye to eye every now and then, isn't it?
Oh, congratulations. I hear you're engaged.
Well, it's not quite like that, but how did you hear it anyway?
I was on duty when Bob Morris came to visit Tracey.
I see. And did he say we were engaged?
Well, no, not exactly. But he did ask her how she'd like to have you in the family. She didn't seem very keen on the idea. They had quite a scene.
Well, he shouldn't have said anything because it's not definite.
Well, he had to say something to cheer her up. She just had this screaming match with some of the women, something about being lesbian or something. She's only got herself to blame.
I don't believe it. He broke the news to her, knowing she had that on her mind?
Oh, come off it, Meg. Now, if she's going to play girly games with Bryant, she's got to expect it to get out.
I see. So you've labelled her a lesbian too?
I'm not the only one.
No. Unfortunately, you're not. Well, I just found her in a cell, trying to slash her wrists with a piece of broken mirror. Bob knew how upset she was all the time to tell her about me. I'm beginning to believe all men are stupid.
Hello.
Oh, Bob, it's Meg here. Now, look, I don't want you to panic, because everything's all right. But Tracy's just tried to slash her wrists.
Oh, my God.
Look, she's all right. I managed to get there in time to stop her.
I'll be straight over.
No, Bob. I think you'd do more harm than good.
But I'm a father, Meg.
Yes, I know you are. But I think it's because of your visit that this has happened.
You mean because I told her about us? Well, I knew she was upset, but I didn't think it would lead to anything like this.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Bob. You didn't think at all. You knew how upset she was about all the rumors going around. You knew how much she needs you.
I thought she'd be pleased at the thought of being part of a whole family.
Look, the only thing she needs right now is you. And she doesn't want to share you, not with anyone. Look, there's nothing to tell her yet. You know that. I only said I'd think about it.
I know, Meg, but you can't blame me for...
Look, I don't know how you can even ask me to think about it, knowing the way Tracy feels.
Even my father didn't really stick up for me. He probably thinks that I'm a lesbian, too. And that Jacki Nolan, she's so vicious. She hated me and she didn't even know me.
Oh, Tracy. I hate seeing you get hurt because of me. I care about you. I think you know that.
I care about you, too.
Well, that's not what I mean. I mean, I love you. I'm sorry, honey. I always knew that you could never feel the same way about me. I always knew that. Well, that didn't matter. Your friendship was enough. Your friendship is enough, and I hope that we'll always be friends.
You're the only friend I've got.
You can get lots more friends if you want to, but I'll always be there.
You all right now, Morris?
She's fine, Mr. Fletcher. She'll be a lot better, though, when these rumors about her stop. I think that it would be good if we weren't seen together so much. So I'd like to ask to be transferred to another cell. Now, that's best, and you know it.
I think Judy's right, Tracy.
You see, Mr. Fletcher, we weren't lovers. We were just friends. And there's a difference, huh?
Excuse me, are you looking for Doreen Burns? I'm her neighbour.
Yes, I was, actually. Would you know where she is?
Well, I should imagine she's probably gone to the country with the baby.
What baby?
Oh, it's a sister's child. She's having a bit of trouble, and Doreen's looking after the baby for a few days while she gets things sorted out. She said she was taking her to the country.
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
Oh, nothing, really. I just didn't know she had a sister.
Oh, neither did I, actually. Well, she said it's her stepsister.
Well, she must have had her hands full looking after the child.
Oh, I don't think so. Anyway, I offered to look after Elizabeth if she needed any help.
Would you mind if I used your phone? I'm afraid it's rather urgent.
Yes, of course.
Yes, may I help you?
Yes, Sister Brooks, please.
Hey, you're the policeman. The one on telly last night. Is it about the kidnapping? Well, have you found anything?
No, we're still working on it. I'd just like to ask Sister Brooks a few more questions.
Oh, yes, I'll tell her you're here.
Oh, please get the doctor quick. There's something wrong. She's breathing funny.
He used to give me roses.
I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.